Hey guys, today we are going to unbox and set up the Ravelli ABSL backdrop stand. Now you know what's inside the package and how to set up the stand. To give you a better look at the product, I'll now take my phone and record some close-up images while talking a bit about the key features. When you're about to decide which backdrop stand to buy, one of your biggest concerns is probably how strong is the crossbar? Will it be able to carry my backdrop, or will it bend in the middle or even break? According to Ravelli, the ABSL crossbar can be used with even the heaviest canvas backdrops. The reason why they can say this so confidently is the fact that they have almost doubled the length of the interconnecting pieces between each section. That is what decide how strong a section-based crossbar is. The two tripod stands can be used for much else than just as a backdrop stand. You can mount just about any type of studio equipment on each of the two tripod stands, thanks to the reversible Mail Studio spigot adapters. I wouldn't hesitate to mount even some of the most expensive cameras on these stands. Maybe the most important reason why I say I would not hesitate to mount my expensive studio gear on it is the fact that these stands are cushioned. Meaning that even if the highly unlikely scenario should occur, where the bottom, middle, or top set screws should loosen, you still have that extra added level of security, since the air cushion design would then make sure that the stands would safely and steadily collapse to their minimum height. Secondly, I don't see this tripod stand tipping over anytime soon, and this is due to the large footprint of the tripod, which is 48 inches when fully extended. But as you can see, I didn't need to extend it that much, since I just wanted it closer to the wall and I only use it as a backdrop stand. The carry bag seems to be doing a great job of protecting what's inside, and in the manual I can read that they actually put some thought into the material, so it should be of high quality at least. Finally, I just want to give you a tip, because since the crossbar is not telescopic but section based, of course, some backdrops will not be 6, 9, 12 or 15 feet wide. It will not fit perfectly, just like you saw mine didn't. I have some space in the sides and it doesn't annoy me, so what I did to stretch out the backdrop was simply to use the rubber bands I had in my house and some normal clamps. That works perfectly for me, but actually I just saw on Amazon that for $10 you can get a set of 12 clamps that is actually made for this purpose. So that's an easy way to get this perfectly stretched backdrop that you want for easy chroma keying. So, I hope you now have a clear idea of what to expect from this product. If you still have any questions, feel free to post them in the comments below and I'll get back to you. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, take care.